I didn't expect to see so many cameras. No, I see. Get a video and
yeah. Thank you. platforms outside.
Tender.
Inside,
yeah. Do you want me to?
No, you're right.
Let's see.
looks like half our group.
No. I had one. I think he still thinks I'm in the German.
Thank you.
don't go up my couch.
Well, I cut them on my phone. We like trams and we like connectors.
Or bricks.
There on the left, yeah. 1980s, 1970s.
You make a good window there.
Just have a look at the rooms. I can't see.
Und in der Vorausstellung einiges über unsere beiden Bergbahnen zu fahren. Sie finden die Route auf der Karte am Ausgang. Ich verabschiede mich von Ihnen und freue mich, Sie bald wieder in unserer Standseilbahn zu begrüßen.
Well, I can't be bothered to hang around here and take some photographs.
Well, he's going to sort of.
Feels like that, doesn't it? There we go.
And I look forward to driving her every day. I don't just want to take you up to the top of the
hill. You must be mad.
I want to give you a quick tour through our suspension railway's history. The opening ceremony for our railway, with its two suspended carriages, took place on the 6th of May 1901, after just 2 years of construction. The Rotterspit hairs, an overhead railway. But the inventor, Eugen Langen, came up with the name suspension railway. Perhaps because of the feeling it gives you of floating uphill. Our railway has been a protected monument since 1975, and cable railway operators believe preserving and maintaining this technical monument is very important. The two suspended carriages are connected to one another by a 38 mm thick and 390 mm long awning. The hoist motor drive unit pulls the back and forth between the stations. This motor, the heart of our railway, is housed in the top station. Every time I see the two drive wheels, I'm blown away by their size. They're an amazing 4 mm in diameter. And each weighs a hefty 15 tons. Incredible, right? There's lots more I can tell you about the technology and modifications to our suspension railway, but the journey is too short. During our roughly 5 minute climb, the route gets steeper and steeper. Just before we reach the top station, the slope is almost 40%. By then, we've gained 84 meters of elevation in our way from Loschwitz to Oberloschwitz and traveled a distance of 274 meters. I've lost count of how many times I've been up and back, but I still enjoy every single trip. Above all, I love the moment when the railway reaches the top station. I step out on the terrace in front of the station, take in the wonderful view of Dresden at my feet. While gliding up and down our suspension railway is my favorite thing to do, exploring Oberloschwitz is a close second, and I can thoroughly recommend it. Prominent figures like the artist Ludwig Richter and composer Rudolf Mauersberger lived here.
Oh, they get it, but they didn't use it.
A flyer is available in the top station that describes a wonderful circular route. If you have enough time, you can extend your walk to the top station of our funicular railway in the Weißeritztalbahn district. You can find the route on the map on the upper plane. The funicular railway will then take you reliably down to Kermerplatz in the valley. It's definitely worth a visit. Now it's time for me to say goodbye. I look forward to seeing you again.
See you going down.
Please do not linger on the platforms, as we can't set off again until the platform is clear and all of the gates are closed.
There you are, I did in English. Are you lucky? I don't have to choose.
He must have known the lady.
It's heavy breathing, isn't it?
This is a cafe up there.
That's the warmth and the coldness.
It's got a cool center. Cool center.
Thank you. Einfahrt 20 Uhr. Vorsicht bei der Einfahrt.
Yeah. Steam trip today. Thank you. Butter muffins. Yes.
of the Barkus there, an IFA Barkus. Thank you. too. Check the other creek. Yeah, that must be the special.
brings you back.
Thank you.
Very good. Germany. So the river might be the border, but Germany's clearly one of the secret borders. Yes, yes it is. Yeah, I'll get off.